We continue tonight our coverage of the Occupy Wall Street protest.
Demonstrators on the streets.
On Occupy Wall Street. Now, the Occupy Wall Street protesters continue to call Lower Manhattan home.
And all this other stuff that goes along with the amassing of debt.
And as Mayor Bloomberg said last week, he said there's going to be riots in the street. If we don't provide jobs right away, there are going to be riots. This is Mayor Bloomberg, the billionaire, talking.
Knowing that somehow this situation can and will be changed.
It seems like nobody cares about the budget. I mean, we're in big trouble, and nobody wants to cut anything.
Began with a small disorganized protest on Wall Street in Lower Manhattan here in New York, has grown today to demonstrations nationwide against corporate greed. From New York to L.A., even...
I want to know about the growing disparity between that 1% of America and the rest, the 99% that are struggling, whether they're unemployed or working two or three jobs.
The biggest threat to our national security is our financial condition.
They see their leaders leading us in the wrong direction. First, they ignore you. Then they ridicule you. Then they fight you. Then you win.
There's a man going around taking names, and he decides who to free and who to blame.
In all,
everybody,
more than 40 people were arrested.
All the same, there'll be a golden ladder reaching down.
Since this country was founded,
when the man comes,
each generation of Americans has been summoned to.
The hairs on your arm will stand up.
Mitt Romney says that Occupy Wall Street is dangerous. In fact, he said, literally, quote, "I think it's dangerous, this class of warfare."
President Obama's continuation of Bush-era policies such as hostile drone war in the Middle East, intervention in Libya.
All the Occupy movement starts with the premise that we all owe them everything. Go get a job right after you take a bath.
They're building up this case just like we did in Iraq. Build up the war propaganda. There was no Al-Qaeda in Iraq, and they had nuclear weapons, and we had to go in. I'm sure you supported that war as well. Okay. It's time we quit this. It's time. It's trillions of dollars we're spending on this war.
I see a red door, and I want it painted black. No colors anymore. I want them to turn black.
This country is in a revolution. They're sick and tired of what they're getting, and I happen to be lucky enough to be part of it.
The Republicans ought to stand for something, and they used to, and I'd like to see that happen again.
The one guy in the field, agree with him or don't agree with him, who doesn't go out of his way to regurgitate talking points or change what he believes to fit the audience he's in front of.
Go to Washington and line up every member of Congress. And I have Ron Paul, who I believe is one of the more honest men in Washington. I say, Ron, point out the honest politician and the dishonest politician.
You can run on for a long time. Run on for a long time. Run on for a long time. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down.